also, you know, Russia is a Christian nationalist nation. They're actually Orthodox Christian. I'm Russian Orthodox. So, you know, I actually support Putin's right to protect his people and always put his people first, but also protect their Christian values. I identify more with Russian, with Putin's Christian values than I do with Joe Biden. So, you know, like there is that, you know, that there is that there. And, you know, Christian nationalist countries also are a threat to the global regime, like the Luciferian regime. It wants to mash everything together. But Putin takes care of his people. He looks out for his people. I watched as he deported, like they literally walked them through the streets, the criminal illegals who were coming into their country. Yeah. They walked them out and they escorted them out and they said, get out. You know, I can respect that. I can respect that. And I can respect the fact that Putin does everything he can to protect his people.
Yeah, she can respect that, and I can respect that because she just wants someone who represents her values. After all, Putin is above all else a devout Christian. That's how I would define his political ideology. Not like the Luciferian Joe Biden. He clearly has some other religious identification, which I don't know what it is, the same as she doesn't know what it is. So I did what you do, which is I popped over to Google and typed in what religion is Joe Biden. It turns out, dear God, he's Roman Catholic? He attends mass at St. Joseph's on the Brandywine? That's weird. I feel like I would integrate that into my screed about the Luciferian world order. And then look, on top of it, obviously, like the idea that Vladimir Putin is just defending his people. I show you this video because she is actually a figure on the right. But also, as a reminder that as bad as Tucker is, it can kind of get a little bit worse. What do you think, Brett?
This is so baddie. This is one of those moments where, so this is Christian nationalism is a very real codified concept. And that concept is that they take a bunch of images of Christianity and then they all coalesce around it and they kind of want to create this new world order alliance with people like Russia. And under the auspices of that being the most American thing, and domestically they want to elect the elected, the God's people. These are the same folks that want to forward like restrictions on voting rights. These are people who flock toward Vladimir Putin because he is so anti-LGBT. And it's so scary because it's not just fantasy. Today, the day that bombs are falling on the Ukraine, the same day that that's happening, there's a Don't Say Gay bill that just passed the Florida legislature. Yesterday, 2 days ago, Abbott calls for investigating the parents of trans youth. This is wildly anti-American. This is government overreach, lifting up the skirts of people's kids because they don't trust their parents, which is the opposite of what they're saying in Virginia around mask wearing and school choice and critical race theory. They only want their people to make the choices. That's the through line, and that is un-American.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. She's a former GOP Senate candidate, by the way, still a big person in the conspiratorial right.
Won the primary.
More about her. Exactly, so didn't end up getting a lot of votes, weirdly. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.